This is Tara from Bridging Apps, and I'm going to show you how to buy music for the first time or download music that you've already purchased on iTunes on your mobile device. You're going to want to open up iTunes. You can search a couple of different ways for music. You can also search for TV shows or movies as well. Now, once you download something, it will remain in your iTunes account, and so anytime you want to put it on another device, you can. You'll just see it in the cloud. So that item, whether it's free or if you purchase it because you have a credit card on file in your iTunes account, it will just live there. Now, you can take things on and off of your device if it's taking up too much of your space. But that's a good thing to know and keep in mind that once it's been downloaded at least one time, it will always have a cloud next to it so you can download it again and you won't have to pay for it. So say I am looking for a song by, we'll just say Duran Duran. So I put that in my search. I can choose between songs and I could toggle back to all. And all would include albums, videos, anything else like that. It's asking me for a sign-in because I probably was not signed in to this device at one time. So I went ahead and signed in. And then I can go ahead and find the song that I'm looking for. It'll have a dollar amount next to it, so maybe $1.29. If it's free, it will say the word get in the box. And if it's something that I've already downloaded, it will have a cloud, and that, again, will be free. What's also great about iTunes is I could tap on the icon to the left, like the picture of the album or the song, and listen to a 30-second clip of the song for absolutely free to make sure it's the right one. So in this case, I'm going to go ahead and purchase this song by tapping on the dollar amount, and then I'll see a circle, well, a square with a circle around it, and that is telling me that my song is downloading. I can then press on play and then hear my song that I've just downloaded. So now to listen to your music, you're going to click on the music icon. And you have some options. You can look at your downloaded music. You can also change that to say library or recently added or even playlist. So I'm going to look at my library. I can see all the songs, but I can also search by albums, by artists. So I'm going to look at the songs that I've already downloaded. I could see a red cloud next to all of the songs I have not downloaded to my device. So I can scroll down and I can find or locate the song that I'd like to add to this device and just tap on the cloud. When I tap on the cloud, I'll be able to see that it is downloading to the device. Again, some songs or files take longer to download. As far as playing music goes, I'm going to show you a couple of shortcuts. On top of the home button, if you swipe up on the actual screen, you'll see a little menu pops up allowing you to play, fast forward, or rewind. It also has volume controls as well. So I can listen to my music from this. I can also just go directly to the music app and hear a song from there. As a shortcut, I could move my music app to the bottom of my dock, which allows me to see the music icon on any screen I'm on. So I would hold down the icon until it wiggles and then move it to the dock. And then from there, I can see what's playing. I can also pause or rewind. And you can just choose what's best for you to be able to play and listen to your music.